Friends, once again I welcome you all. Today we are going to learn and see about the Autonomous District Council, which has been making news these days. We'll see what are Autonomous District Council, which all are the constitutional provisions related to it, why there is a demand for Autonomous District Council in the state of Arunachal, and what should be the way out. Now, this lecture is the part of our online current affairs series. Now, you must be seeing in the newspaper, today even the newspaper has the headlines that there is a demand for Mon ADC along with that of Patkai ADC in the state of Arunachal. Let us try and understand what is Mon ADC and Patkai ADC. This topic will be important from prelims point of view as well as from the mains point of view as well. Har saal mains mein question pucha jata hai, define ADC, ya fir should ADC be brought in the state of Arunachal Pradesh, ya fir एग्जामिन करने को आपको बोला जाता है. 5 to 10 मार्क्स का हर बार ये क्वेश्चन पूछा जाता है. नाउ लेट्स ट्राई एंड अंडरस्टैंड व्हाई देयर इज अ डिमांड फॉर एडीसी इन द स्टेट ऑफ अरुणाचल. दिस इज नॉट अ न्यू इशू, रादर दिस इज अ लॉन्ग पेंडिंग डिमांड ऑफ द मोनपा कम्युनिटी रिसाइडिंग in the western part of Arunachal, though they are distributed throughout the Arunachal, but majority of the population they reside in the western part, which include the district of Tawang as well as West Kameng. Now, combining the two district of Tawang and West Kameng, they are demanding for a Monpa Autonomous District Council. And on the eastern side, the district of Changlang, the district of Tirap and Longding, combining the three districts, there has been a demand of Patkai ADC. So here it is mentioned that Monpa ADC, Autonomous District Council, includes the district of Tawang and West Kameng, and the Patkai ADC includes the three districts of Changlang, Tirap and Longding. Now, first of all, let's try to understand which all are the constitutional provisions related to it. Now, this is very important from your prelims perspective. You all must be knowing about the 5th schedule and 6th schedule of the Indian Constitution. The 5th schedule deals with the scheduled areas and the tribal areas throughout the territory of India, except for 4 states of Assam, Meghalaya, Tripura and Mizoram. And these 4 states are covered in the next schedule, that is 6th schedule. Why the distinction has been made between the 5th schedule and the 6th schedule? In the 6th schedule, those states are kept in which the tribal during the time of independence they were more backward. So 6th schedule ke andar un states ko rakha gaya hai jin states mein tribals independence ke time mein jyada backward the, aur backward kis sense mein, socially as well as economically. Us samay to throughout the territory of India education utna developed nahi tha, lekin backwardness ka jo do benchmark tha, ek tha social backwardness, dusra tha economic backwardness. तो ऐसे जो भी ट्राइबल स्टेट्स हुआ करते थे, जिसका हमने मेंशन किया, जिसके बारे में असम, मेघालय, त्रिपुरा एंड मिजोरम, इन चारों को 6th शेड्यूल में रखा गया है और रेस्ट जो भी शेड्यूल्ड एरियाज और ट्राइबल एरियाज हैं उनको 5th शेड्यूल के अंदर रखा गया है. नाउ लेट्स सी the constitutional provisions related to autonomous district council. The fifth schedule covers the administration and control of schedule areas and schedule tribes in any of the state, in any of the Indian state, except the four states of AMTM. The sixth schedule, on the other hand, covers for the administration of tribal areas in the four northeastern states of AMTM. Now, there is a question for you. Arunachal Pradesh comes under which schedule? Is it the fifth schedule or sixth schedule? Arunachal comes under sixth schedule. Why is it so? It is so because Arunachal was a part of Assam till 1971, and through an act called State Reorganization Act of 1971, NEFA was carved out of the Assam region. It was carved out as a UT, and further it has been given the statehood later on. So Arunachal comes under 6th schedule, and it was separated by Assam as a UT by States Reorganization Act of 1971. We have discussed that scheduled areas means the areas which lack social and economic forwardness, or we can say socially and economically backward areas, are considered as scheduled areas. Now, once in the mains, there has been a question in UPSC mains, why scheduled tribes and scheduled caste, they are being appended by a word scheduled. If you know, then you can write down in the comment box why scheduled caste, in the caste, scheduled caste and scheduled tribe, the word schedule has been appended. Now, to regulate the states mentioned in the fifth schedule as well as sixth schedule, we have Article 244 of the Indian Constitution, which comes under Part 10, which has special system of administration for scheduled and tribal areas. So this article also becomes very important. Under Article 244, which comes under Part 10 of the Indian Constitution, there is a provision for administration of the states covered under these schedule. So it is Article 244. Now, the sixth schedule, just now we have discussed, it provides limited autonomy to the tribal areas of the northeastern states, and this sixth schedule was a result of the Bardoloi committee, which was set up by the Constituent Assembly when our constitution was being drafted. So this is again important from prelims point of view. This might be asked in your exam, that sixth schedule is a result of which of the following committees? So it is a result of Bardoloi committee. Now, what is the basis as to why there is a need for limited autonomy to the tribal areas of the northeastern states? The basis is simply because it allows the tribal areas to develop, which were underdeveloped, and in this schedule, it will protect the tribals from exploitation and will preserve their distinct social customs. So yahan pe idea ye hai ki aise tribal areas jo ki underdeveloped the independence ke time mein, socially as well as economically, un logo ko limited autonomy diya jaye apne area ko administer karne ke liye, aur unko kuch power diya jaye, unko empower kiya jaye with legislative function, executive function, judicial function, so that they can manage their own affairs and can develop themselves. On one side, they can preserve their traditional customs. On another side, they can go with the modern laws or along with the constitution. Now, what are autonomous district councils? Now, they are the councils, they are the special bodies which represent autonomous district within the state legislature. At present, in Northeast, 10 autonomous district council are recognized, 3 each in Meghalaya, Mizoram and Assam, and 1 in Tripura. So this is again, this can be a probable question in your prelims as to how many autonomous district council exist in the state of or in the northeastern region. So there are 10 autonomous district council in the entire northeastern region, 3 each in Meghalaya, Mizoram and Assam, and 1 in the Tripura. In Meghalaya, the ADCs are named on the basis of hills, that is Khasi, Jaintia and Garo hills ADCs. In Mizoram, we have Chakma, Lai and Mara ADCs. In Assam, we have Dima Hasao, Karbi Anglong and Bodoland territorial ADCs. In Tripura, we have Tripura tribal areas ADCs. So, आपको नाम याद रखना जरूरी नहीं है, बट ये ध्यान में रखना होगा कि कितने ADCs हैं नॉर्थ ईस्टर्न रीजन में और किस स्टेट में कितने ADCs हैं. हाउ मेनी ADCs आर देयर इन अरुणाचल एट प्रेजेंट? इट इज nil. नाउ ईच ऑटोनमस डिस्ट्रिक्ट काउंसिल शैल हैव एन ऑटोनमस डिस्ट्रिक्ट consisting of 30 members. Now, अब अगर autonomous district council acknowledge किया जाता है तो उसके अंदर कई सारे tribes reside कर सकते हैं, अलग अलग tribes reside कर सकते हैं, तो वहाँ पर फिर अलग अलग regional council भी बनाया जा सकता है. So, एक autonomous district council के अंदर, एक ADC के अंदर कई सारे regional council बनाए जा सकते हैं अगर वहाँ पे अलग अलग tribal population है तब. So, each autonomous region within a ADC have a regional council. Now, the acts of parliament and state legislature do not apply to autonomous district or autonomous regions. This is a very important point. जो भी parliament के acts होते हैं या state legislature के acts होते हैं वो ADCs में implement नहीं होते हैं, या फिर अगर होते हैं तो उनको modify किया जा सकता है या फिर उन पर certain exceptions लगाया जा सकता है by the governor of that state. So, governor of the state in which ADC exists, he has got certain special rights. Now, the center has given legislative and executive autonomy to the district and regional council. Again, a very important point. Center has given the legislative and executive autonomy to district and regional council. Now, the district council are responsible for regulating the infrastructure, roads, education, healthcare, social customs and so on, which requires governor assent. So, ye jo ADCs hote hain, they have got special rights and they are responsible for regulating infrastructure, roads, healthcare, social customs, if they get the assent of the governor. Now, how are the members of ADCs appointed? They are appointed basically by an election process. Each autonomous district council consists of 30 members. Out of those 30 members, 4 are nominated by the governor of the state. 26 are elected via election process through adult franchisee. So, 4 are nominated by the government, 26 are elected members. The term of each member is 5 years. The 4 members which are nominated by the governor, they hold the post on the pleasure of the governor. That means governor jab bhi chahe tab unko hata sakta hai un post se. Moving next. The autonomous district council, they also enjoy certain judicial power and legislative power. In judicial power, they have both civil and criminal judicial power. दे कैन एडमिनिस्टर देयर एरिया, और उनके पास ये पावर होता है कि वो सिविल एंड क्रिमिनल जुडिशियल प्रोनाउंसमेंट सुना सकते हैं, बट देयर ज्यूरिसडिक्शन इज सब्जेक्टेड टू द कंसर्न हाई कोर्ट, जो वहाँ पे हाई कोर्ट होगा, जैसे अरुणाचल का गुवाहाटी हाई कोर्ट है, तो जो भी ADC के जजमेंट होंगे वो दे विल बी सब्जेक्टेड टू द हाई कोर्ट ऑफ गुवाहाटी. Now, just now I have mentioned that governor of the state having ADC enjoys certain rights, special rights. So, which all are the special rights which governor enjoy in the states having ADCs? Let's see one by one. Now, the governor is empowered to take decision under the areas in the sixth schedule. He can reorganize the boundaries of such autonomous district. Reorganize the boundaries of autonomous district council का मतलब क्या है, या फिर autonomous district का boundary को reorganize करने का मतलब क्या है, जो भी autonomous district declare कर दिए गए हैं उनके boundary को वो expand कर सकता है, उनको वो restrict कर सकता है, वो दो district को या तीन district को unite कर सकता है, merge कर सकता है, या फिर किसी भी autonomous district का नाम को वो change कर सकता है. So he can unite two or more autonomous district or part of them. He can alter the name of any autonomous district, and he may appoint a commission to examine and report on the administration of ADCs. So you need to remember that governor of the state in which ADC exists has got certain special right. Which all right? He nominates 4 members of the ADCs. He can reorganize the boundaries of the autonomous district. Reorganization का मतलब क्या है? Can unite, can alter, as well as he can also appoint a commission to examine and report on the administration of ADCs. Moving next, since हमने देख लिया कि ADCs जो होते हैं वहां पे autonomy दिया जाता है उस autonomous district को अपने लेजिस्लेटिव फंक्शन के लिए, वो अपने लिए लॉ बना सकते हैं, उनके पास जुडिशियल पावर रहता है सब्जेक्टेड टू रिव्यू बाय द हाई कोर्ट, उनके पास एग्जीक्यूटिव फंक्शंस होते हैं, लेकिन देर आर सर्टेन ड्रॉबैक्स एसोसिएटेड विथ ADCs. विच ऑल आर द ड्रॉबैक्स? लेट्स सी. देर कैन बी कॉन्फ्लिक्ट ऑफ इंटरेस्ट बिटवीन द ADCs एंड स्टेट लेजिस्लेचर. जैसा कि हमने डिस्कस किया कि जो स्टेट लेजिस्लेचर के लॉज होते हैं वो ADC के अंदर विथ मॉडिफिकेशन इंप्लीमेंट किया जाता है. सो देयर कैन बी अ सिचुएशन वेयर कॉन्फ्लिक्ट कैन अकर बिटवीन द स्टेट लेजिस्लेचर एज वेल एज द लॉज मेड बाय द रिस्पेक्टिव ADCs. सेकेंडली, द डिस्ट्रिक्ट काउंसिल हैव मोर पावर दैन द लोकल गवर्नमेंट्स ऑफ पंचायत एंड म्यूनिसिपैलिटीज. That means there is a conflict between two constitutional provision. On one hand, the sixth schedule. On the other hand, 73rd and 74th amendment. Now, there is a demand for special provisions from other groups as well. There can be a demand for similar district council from other groups as well. Now, there exists a financial gap between what is being demanded by the ADC and what is being given by the state government. So, ADC कई बार अपने proposal रखेंगे, ज़्यादा finance का demand रखेंगे, but अगर state legislature उनके financial demand को heed नहीं करेगा, तो as a result of which the development is going to suffer. So, these can be the drawbacks of ADCs. अगेन वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, आपको पता होना चाहिए ADCs बनाने के बेनिफिट क्या हैं, उनके ड्रॉबैक्स क्या हैं, क्योंकि ये मेंस के हिसाब से भी इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक है. नाउ गोइंग इनटू द हिस्ट्री ऑफ द नीड फॉर ADCs, लाइक यू ऑल नो, इन 1873 द ब्रिटिश एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन इन इंडिया दे इनैक्टेड द बंगाल ईस्टर्न Frontier Regulation Act टू सेफ गार्ड द ट्राइबल्स ऑफ ईस्टर्न पार्ट्स ऑफ बंगाल. सो द ब्रिटिशर्स दे पास्ड बंगाल ईस्टर्न फ्रंटियर रेगुलेशन एक्ट टू सेफ गार्ड द ट्राइबल्स इन द नॉर्थ ईस्टर्न रीजन. Now, with this Bengal Eastern Frontier Regulation Act of 1873, the year is important, it can be asked. With this, inner line permit was introduced in some of the states of the northeastern region. Inner line permit kya hai? Any Indian who want to visit, enter into the territory of some of the states of northeastern region, then they need special pass to enter into the tribal areas. इसी को हम बोलते हैं inner line permit. So बिना inner line permit के ILP के कोई भी Indian जो कि इस state में reside नहीं करता है, उस particular northeastern state में reside नहीं करता है, वो enter नहीं कर सकता है. And the provision of ILP exists in four of the northeastern state, that is Arunachal, Nagaland, Mizoram and recently मणिपुर में भी आईएलपी का कॉन्सेप्ट लाया गया है. सो अगेन इम्पॉर्टेंट फॉर प्रिलिम्स, पूछा जा सकता है कितने स्टेट में आईएलपी एग्जिस्ट करता है. सो फोर स्टेट, अरुणाचल, नागालैंड, मिजोरम एंड मणिपुर. नाउ रिसेंटली मेघालय स्टेट लेजिस्लेटिव असेंबली हैज ऑल्सो अडॉप्टेड अ रेजोल्यूशन डिमांडिंग इम्प्लीमेंटेशन ऑफ आईएलपी, बट सो फार द गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया हैज नॉट given a positive response on it. We'll have to wait and see. Moving next, now the demand for Mon ADC is not new, it is rather a 17 year old demand, and the demand is being pushed by a committee which has been formed for this purpose, that is Mon Autonomous Region Demand Committee. Mon Autonomous Region Demand Committee, which is pushing for this Mon ADC. And in fact, the Legislative Assembly of Arunachal has passed with a resolution that Mon ADC should be acknowledged and it should be established as a autonomous district council back in the year 2004. But again the decision is pending from the government of India side. Yahi yahan pe likha hua hai, aap ek bar dekh lijiyega. Recently the committee, Mon Autonomous Region Demand Committee, has submitted memorandum to the chief minister of the state. Now, according to the committee, their demand of Mon Autonomous District Council is in line with the provisions of Constitution of India, which is mentioned under the Sixth Schedule. Sixth Schedule में जैसा कि हमने discuss किया अभी कि उसमें जो भी tribal areas हैं चार state के, असम, मेघालय, त्रिपुरा एंड मिजोरम, उन tribal areas के अंदर limited autonomy दिया जाएगा अपने एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन करने के लिए अपने एरिया को. सो इस कमिटी का ये कहना है कि जो भी वो डिमांड कर रहे हैं, इट इज़ इन कॉन्सोनेंस विद द प्रोविजन ऑफ द इंडियन कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन अंडर सिक्स शेड्यूल. नाउ मॉन एडीसी में जो मॉन वर्ड है, इट स्टैंड्स फॉर मोनपा कम्युनिटी विच आर बुद्धिस्ट बाई रिलीजन एंड दे हैव डिस्टिंक्ट एज ओल्ड कल्चर, script and tradition. Their demand is aimed at preserving their culture, tradition, script and language through self-governance. Now they are demanding it because they want to administer their areas based on the policies and plans which will be formed by themselves, and according to them it is just a blending of the traditional system of self-governance with the modern methods within the provisions of the constitution. Now what is the challenge in giving or in formation of autonomous district council in the state of Arunachal? According to constitutional experts, In the sixth schedule, four states are mentioned, that is the state of Assam, Meghalaya, Tripura and Mizoram. And the scheduled area provision for creation of ADC has not been mentioned in the constitution for Arunachal Pradesh. So since Arunachal Pradesh ko recognize nahi kiya gaya tha jab constitution ko draft kiya ja raha tha, to अरुणाचल के पास ये स्पेशल प्रोविजन नहीं है ऑटोनोमस डिस्ट्रिक्ट काउंसिल बनाने का, ऐसा कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल एक्सपर्ट का कहना है. क्यों? क्योंकि अरुणाचल जो है वो 1971 में स्टेट रीऑर्गेनाइजेशन एक्ट के थ्रू असम से बाहर निकला है. सेकेंडली, द स्टूडेंट यूनियंस ऑफ द अरुणाचल हैज बीन अपोजिंग इट ऑन द ग्राउंड दैट इट इज गोइंग टू लीड टू सेवरल डिमांड बाई अदर community by other district for similar autonomous district council. So it will lead to secessionist tendency. It will open floodgates for similar demands from various regions in the state. Now, what should be the way out? Now you know why there is a demand for autonomous district council. You know which all are the drawbacks, what all are the challenges. So वे आउट क्या होना चाहिए? देर इज अ क्वेश्चन विच आई हैव मेंशनड हियर. द क्वेश्चन सेज फॉर्मेशन ऑफ ऑटोनोमस डिस्ट्रिक्ट काउंसिल शुड बी अलाउड इन द स्टेट ऑफ अरुणाचल प्रदेश. यू नीड टू एग्जामिन दिस स्टेटमेंट. आई रिक्वेस्ट यू ऑल टू राइट इन द कमेंट सेक्शन एंड नॉट मोर देन 100 वर्ड्स. जो भी पहले 10 लोग होंगे जिन्होंने रिप्लाई करेंगे, आई विल गो थ्रू इट एंड आई विल गिव कमेंट ऑन दैट. Now, like you all must be knowing, our online classes has begun from 29th of July and we are going to start with our regular classes from the coming Monday. So those who are interested, they can enroll now. Thank you and have a great day.